I'm Julia Child. Welcome to this volume of our video book, The Way to Cook.
A quick recipe and demo of rosemary ribeye and blue cheese steaks. I've got a little bit of melted butter there. These are pretty thick steaks, so I don't need a steak press on there because they're going to be on there for a little bit, even for a medium rare, where I'm pretty sure I'm going to get a good Maillard reaction. And I'm aiming for the rare side of medium rare. We'll go ahead and give these a flip. I think I can turn the heat up on this a little bit. Now that I flipped them, I added a little bit of a garlic compound butter that I made and then put some rosemary on top, and that's really going to bring that rosemary garlic butter flavor into the ribeye. And since I got the grill already heated up, why not make use of the space and let's fry up a little bit of mushrooms. Oh, and look at these. Oh, they're being so good. I moved the rosemary off to the side, flipped the steaks, added fresh butter, and the rosemary is gonna go right back on top. The ribeyes are definitely rare at this point with a great crust on them. So I just took them off and I put that side of the grill to off, and they will probably rise to a medium rare. And I moved the mushrooms over to get all that good flavor from the ribeyes. Mushrooms are done. My last little trick is a little asparagus, extra virgin olive oil, and fresh garlic. And then just to limit the time on the grill, because you don't want these things to be overdone, which I consider anything more than medium rare, I just got my little warming dome, maybe about 28 seconds, and that blue cheese will have a nice melt to it. Oh, and these mushrooms are looking good. If you noticed, I've not seasoned the mushrooms at all. They're just picking up flavor from the grill and butter. I did put a little melted area butter there, and I'm gonna add some garlic to that. And we're just going to get it soft and buttery. And then we're going to add that to the mushrooms. Oh, and I really don't like my garlic being overdone, so I did turn the grill to off. The asparagus is just turning out to be wonderful as well. And just like that, everything's done. Look at those delicious garlic mushrooms. Look at how that asparagus fried up. Let's go in and plate this up and eat. And here's our final product. Maybe a little bit, the blue cheese could have melted a little bit more, but I did not want to compromise the integrity of my medium rare by adding any more heat to that piece of meat. And here's the money shot, that all I did was get a warm center at best. So that should be pretty close to a medium rare.
I don't think it negates anything.
I can't tell you guys just how good this tastes. That rosemary just bled through into the steak. One last thing with the asparagus is I cook it not until it's soggy, but just until it's about ready to lose its crunch. If that makes any sense. And not to belabor the asparagus, but if you've got a lime, when you take them off, hit them with a little bit of fresh lime. Bon appetit, and this video is now concluded. Oh, and before I put the steaks on the grill, they were seasoned with salt. and pepper. Now for real, the video's over.